Right, good morning everyone. Welcome to the next session in Java. So far in the previous couple of sessions, we have started the discussing about constructors in Java and default constructor in Java. So till now we have seen that if we have defined a class called as class A. So if you have defined a class called as A, right? And if you save the code with A.java, and if you compile this code, so Java compiler is going to add one constructor because your class do not contain any constructor. So if your class contains the constructor, it is okay. If you don't maintain a constructor inside a class, then Java compiler is going to do is going to add a default constructor, and the default constructor will have a single statement inside that one. So the name of the statement is super, right? So this is what we have studied in brief in the previous session. So when we define a class, if we have a constructor in it, it is okay, it will be compiled. And if you don't have a constructor inside a class, then a new constructor will be created by Java compiler. The new constructor is a zero parameter and zero statement, but the fact is that it is zero parameter, but not zero statement. Each and every constructor will have a super keyword as the statement, right? So, and for example, in the same class, I have already a constructor. I have already a constructor which is going to print some ECE on the output screen, right? Which is going to print ECE on the output screen. So now, if I compile this class A, so this class A already contains a constructor. Now, what the Java compiler will do is that it will check whether the constructor is there or not. So there is constructor, it is okay. If there is no constructor, it will add a constructor. If there is a constructor, it will go into the body of the constructor and verifies whether there is a super keyword or not. So if you verify, this is the body of the constructor, it is the starting point and it is the ending point for the body of the constructor. And it will verify whether there is a super keyword inside the constructor body or not. So if there is super keyword, it will be executed. If there is no super keyword inside the body of the constructor, then what the compiler is going to do is, it is going to add a super keyword as a first statement inside the constructor, right? So see here, if we don't define super keyword inside the constructor, Java compiler is going to add the super keyword as a first statement inside the body of the constructor. So this is what we have learned so far in the previous session. Now, let us start the things in today's session. So let us start with the 17th point. So the 17th point is that if we want to define a super keyword inside a constructor, then we have to define it as a first statement inside the body of the constructor. See here. So till now, we have discussed that if there is a constructor in your class, and if that constructor is get compiled, Java compiler will suggest for the super keyword inside the body of the constructor. If it founds the super keyword, that super keyword will get executed. If it don't have the super keyword inside the body of a constructor, Java compiler is going to add the super keyword, and then it is going to be compiled. So now what happens if I want to define a super keyword myself inside the body of the constructor? So if I want to define a super keyword inside the body of the constructor, then I have to define it as a first statement inside the body of the constructor. So if you want to define a super keyword inside the constructor, then define it as a first statement. Don't go for the second or third or the last statement. So if you go for the second or third or the last statement for the super keyword inside the body of the constructor, it is going to lead in compile time error. So see the things in the program. So this is where we stopped in the previous session. So for example, here I have this method is going to print something called as good morning on the output screen, right? Now inside the main method, we had created an object for class A. So whenever the class A's object has been created, it is going to execute the constructor which was present in class A, right? And as we discussed earlier, whenever the compiler is going to execute this constructor, it will search for the super keyword inside the body of the constructor. If there is no super keyword, now the compiler is going to add the super keyword as a first statement inside the constructor. So whenever it is added and whenever it is encountered by the Java virtual machine, then it will search for the super class for class A. So the super class for class A is class B. Immediately, it is going to execute the class B's constructor. After executing the class B's constructor, this statement will get executed, right? So this is generally what will happen, right? Now, see here. Right, this is where we stopped in the previous session. Right, we had studied that if there is a constructor inside the class, the constructor will get executed. If the constructor inside the class do not have a super keyword, then Java compiler is going to add a super keyword as a first statement inside the constructor. So whenever we create an object, the class A's constructor will get executed. When the body of the class A it started executing, the first statement inside the constructor is that super keyword. So immediately it will go for the super class constructor and it will execute the super class constructor. Right? It will execute the super class constructor. So after executing the super class constructor, it is going to execute the remaining lines of the base class constructor, sorry, subclass. And then when we call method M, it has executed the method M which was present in class U. So this is what all we have seen in the previous session. So now we are going to look at the 17th point here. So see the 16th and then we can move to the 17th. If we don't define super keyword inside the constructor, Java compiler is going to add super keyword as a first statement inside the body of the constructor. So if you have written a constructor and if you don't define a super keyword, Java compiler is going to add a super keyword as a first statement inside the body of the constructor. Now, what I want to do, if I want to define a super keyword inside the constructor. So if we want to define, if the programmer want to define a super keyword inside the constructor, what he or she has to do. So then we have to define it as a first statement inside the body of the constructor. So if you want to define it as a, if you want to define a super keyword inside the body, so you have to define it as a first statement. So if you define it as a second or third or last statement, it is going to lead and compile time error, right? So see here, see in the program, in this constructor, we don't have a super keyword. And similarly, in this constructor also, we don't have a super keyword. But when we compile this code, Java compiler is going to verify. It will be very careful. It will verify whether there is a super keyword or not. If there is no super keyword, it is going to add super keyword, right? It is going to add super keyword here and here, right? So now I want to define a super keyword myself. Right, I want to define a super keyword myself. Now, what I have to do if I want to define a super keyword myself? So, if I want to define a super keyword, I need to define it as a first statement inside the body. So, if I want to define a super keyword, I have to define it as a first statement. Now, let us see. Let us see whether it will give the correct output or not. So good night, good morning, and good evening has been printed on the output screen. So let us verify. So each and every program will start from main method, right? So first we have created an object for class A. Now class A's constructor will get executed automatically. That's what we have studied in the last before session, that the constructor will not be executed explicitly. They will be executed automatically during the time of object creation. So whenever we create an object, the constructor which was present in class A will get executed. So the control will shift here. So class A's constructor will start executing. So inside the class A's constructor, we found that there is super keyword defined by the programmer. Then immediately it will execute the super class constructor. So who is the super class constructor? B is the super class constructor. What happens if B was executed? So if B is executed, so if B is executed, we are going, it is going to, when B is executed, there is one more super keyword inside B. So compiler will verify, is there any super class for class B or not? So there is no super class for class B. So it will print good night on the output screen. After printing good night on the output screen, the control is going to return to the next line in class A. So it is going to print good morning. After these two things, we have called method M. So when method M is called, it is going to print good evening. So this is what will happen. Now let us check what happens if I make it as a second statement, or if I made it as a last statement inside the body of a constructor. So see here, in A.java, so program name is A.java. At line number 14, I got an error. Call to super must be first statement in constructor super keyword. So the error is that, see the error. The error is that it is at line number 14. So see here, the line number 14, we have written the super keyword. So there is no mistake in writing the super keyword. We have followed all the rules and regulations here. We had maintained all the small letters for representing the super keyword. We had opened the parenthesis, closed the parenthesis, and used the semicolon. So it is syntactically perfect, but still we are getting an error. So why we got an error, in the sense, if you want to define it super keyword, so in the error also they had mentioned it, a super must be the first statement in constructor. So if you want to maintain the super keyword, maintain it as a first statement, or else you can leave it. So the compiler is going to add a constructor to your class, right? And now let us discuss about So this is what the default constructor means. A constructor which is having the zero parameters is called as default constructor. Now let us see what is a constructor with, right? What is a constructor with, or what is a parameterized constructor? So a parameterized constructor Now let us see this one. When a constructor is having one or more number of parameters, then it is called as parameterized constructor. So when a constructor is having one or more number of parameters, then it is said to be a parameterized constructor, right? So here, till now in the program, we don't maintain any parameters. For example, if I have written something called as int a, right? If I have written something called as int a, the meaning of this one, we are maintaining one integer parameter for constructor b. Now, if we compile and run the code, just a second, we got an error at line number 11. Okay, at line number 11. Yeah, okay. So see here, let us first let us see this one for this, and I will explain the thing for what we got error. So see here, now I had maintained an integer parameter for class A. Now see here, if I compile this one, just a second. Right, see here. So during the time of object creation, see here, we had a constructor which is going to take one integer parameter, right, and while we creating an object for the class, we all know that the constructor will get executed during the time of object creation. So when we try to create an object with this syntax or with this zero parameters, we are going to get a compile time error because class A is already having a constructor which is having an integer parameter. So if you want to execute this constructor, we need to pass an integer value here. Otherwise, we may get a compile time error. So during the time of object creation, right, pass an integer value. It may be an any integer value. For example, 2, 10, 1, minus 1, minus 10, any integer value. So if you pass such an integer value, right, then it is going to be compiled successfully. So it got compiled successfully. Now, if I run this one, again, I am going to get an output of good night, good morning, good evening, right? So it is called as parameterized constructor. So we can have a single parameter, or we can have a multiple parameters, or we can have a parameters of different types, right? Parameters of different types, character D. Now, if we want to execute this constructor, we need to pass an integer value, comma, two integer values, comma, followed by floating point value and followed by character value. So see here, we need to pass two integer values. It may be any integer values, right? 2, 3, then we have to pass a floating point value. In order to say it has a float point value, we need to append f at the end of the value. And then we need to pass a character, any character. So if we do this one and if we compile this one, then there is no chance of getting errors. But if you missed any one parameter, even if you have given three parameters and if you missed even one parameter, you are going to get a compile time error, right? So this is what the we call what we call these parameterized constructors. Now let us see. This is having a parameter of int a. It is having a parameter of int a, and our superclass is also having a parameter of int b, right? Now let us see what will be the output of this code. Right, see here. So without these four lines, what I have deleted so far, we are getting an error. See here. Why we got an error in such cases? So if I compile this one with the code, what you are seeing on the screen, I got an error at line number 12. So see here, as we discussed earlier, if there is a constructor in our class, and if there is no super keyword for that constructor, compiler is going to add a super keyword here as a first statement. So whenever the super keyword is added, the compiler is going to execute the super class default constructor. Right? So only the super class default constructor can be executed automatically. But if you observe, in the superclass B, there is no default constructor. Only we are having a constructor B of integer parameter, that is a parameterized constructor. So if you want to execute this parameterized constructor, we need to pass an integer value. Other than passing an integer value, it will get never executed. So now what the compiler is telling is, I have added a super keyword here. Right, I have added a super keyword here while compiling, but when JVM is executing this program, it has found that there is no default constructor in class B. So there is no default constructor in class B. That's why it is showing an error. So what we have to do, right, in order to avoid such errors? The first one is that we can maintain a default constructor. So if you maintain a default constructor, so let us see the output of this code, then you can understand it somewhat better. See here, the output is good morning and good evening. See here, we have created an object for class A, right? Immediately, this constructor will start executing. So inside the constructor, we don't maintain any super keyword, but Java compiler will add a super keyword. When JVM encounters that super keyword, it is going to see the super class constructor. The super class is B. In B, there are two constructors, constructor with no parameters and constructor with one parameter. So here, the default constructor is going to be executed automatically. That's why we got good as an output instead of good night. After executing the default constructor, good morning will be printed. And then we had made a call to method EM. Good evening will be printed on the output screen. Now, my question is that what I have to do in order to get good night on the output screen. If I want to get good night on the output screen, I need to call a constructor which is going to take one integer parameter. Now, what I have to do in order to print good night on the output screen in the sense, I need to maintain a super keyboard where this super keyboard will pass one integer value. If I do this one super of 2, then the constructor in the super class, which is having one integer parameter, is going to be executed. See, now I got the output as good night. Right? I think this is a bit confusing. So please be clear. And if anybody is having any doubts in today's session till now, please raise your hand. If it is clear, we can move to the constructor overloading. If anybody is having the doubts, please raise your hand. Then, okay. I'm going to move to the constructors overloading. Constructor overloading. See here. In the method overloading, we have discussed that same program, same class, same method name, different parameter profile. Right? This is what the method overloading. Here, the constructor overloading is that same program, same class, right? Same method name, right? Same method name, where the method name is same as class name. Where the method name is same as class name. And then different parameter profile. So different parameter profile in the sense, there may be difference in terms of type of parameters or order of parameters or number of parameters. So if there is any difference in any three, any one or any two or any three, then it is called as different parameter profile. So in order to do a constructor overloading, we need to be in the same program. We need to do it in the same class. We need to maintain the same method name, where the name of the method should be same as the class name. If the class name is A, then the method name should also be A. Right? And there should be different parameter profile. That is, there should be difference in terms of type, number, or order of parameters. So see in the program, let us keep them side by side and we can work on it. Right, see here. I have a class S. Inside this one, I am going to have a couple of constructors. First one is a default constructor, and the second one is an parameterized constructor, which is going to take a single integer value. And the third one is that it is going to take a single float value. And I have the fourth one. And I have the fourth one. So I have int a comma float b. And similarly, I have the fifth one, float b comma int a. Now see here, we are in the same program, so it is satisfied. We are in the same class, yes, it is satisfied. We are with the same method name, where the method name is same as class name. So here the class name is s, first method name is s, second method name is s, all the method names are s, right? So we have satisfied this one also, and different parameter profile. So see here whether we satisfied the different parameter profile or not. Right, see here. Here there is zero parameters. Here there is one parameter. Here there is one parameter. Here there are two parameters. Here also there are two parameters. So here there is some clashes in terms of number of parameters. Let us see the type of parameters. So here there are zero parameters, so there is no issue. Here the type is integer. Here the type is floating point number, and here the type is integer comma float, and float comma integer. So here also there is nothing, right? And then let us see the order of parameters. So if you observe the last two, the order of parameters is int comma float and float comma int. So we had maintained different parameter profile. So let us cross verify each and every one with another one. So let us take this first one. So first one, we have zero parameters. It is different from the second constructor or the third constructor, fourth and fifth in terms of number of parameters. If you consider the second one, it has matching the third one in terms of number of parameters, but in terms of type of parameters, it is having the int and the third one is having the float. So there is some difference in terms of type of parameters. And if you observe the last two, both are having equal number of parameters, both are having the type of parameters integer and floating point, but the order is that the fourth one is having the integer parameter followed by floating point parameter, and the fifth one is having the floating point parameter followed by integer parameter. So it is perfectly, we had overloaded the constructors, right? And in simple steps, we can say that. So this is what the constructor overloading is there. You can see, you can observe, there are two methods which are having the same name, yes, and the class name is also yes. The first one is having zero parameters, and the second one is having single integer parameters. So there is some difference in terms of number of parameters. So it is a constructor overloading. And similarly, if I maintain float b, now there is one parameter in first method and there is one parameter in second method, but here the type of parameter is float and the type of parameter is integer. So there is some difference in terms of type of parameters here. It is constructor overloading. And one more thing, I have float b comma int a, and here I have int a comma float b. Now both are having the two parameters. In both I have integer, in both I have floating point. So there is no difference in terms of number of parameters. There is no difference in terms of type of parameters. Both are having integer and floating point. But the difference is that the first method will have the float followed by integer, and the second method will have int followed by the float. So there is some difference in terms of order of parameters. So it is also called as constructor overloading. So here we can maintain the difference in any one thing, right? So with this, I am going to close today's session. So if anybody is having the doubts in today's session, you can raise your hands. And in tomorrow's session, we are going to see some examples on constructor overloading. If anybody is having the doubts, please raise your hands. Okay. So in tomorrow's session, we are going to cover the topic of constructor, examples on constructor overloading. So in today's session, we have seen about the super keyword. If we want to add a super keyword, where we have to add it inside the constructor. And then we had seen about the constructor overloading, right? And thank you very much.